I will praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will tell of your name to my kin. Alleluia. Today's Holy Mass is being offered up for the repose of the soul of Mark Milanek. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, life of the faithful, glory of the humble, blessedness of the just, listen kindly to the prayers of those who call on you, that they who thirst for what is generously promised may always have their fill of your plenty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The word of God continued to spread and grow. After Barnabas and Saul completed their relief mission, they returned to Jerusalem, taking with them John, who is called Mark. Now they were in the church at Antioch, prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simeon, who is called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manian, who is a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called to them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and sent them off. So they, sent forth by the Holy Spirit, went down to Seleucia, and from there sailed to Cyprus. When they arrived in Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in the Jewish synagogues. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May God have pity on us and bless us. May he let his face shine upon us. So may your way be known upon earth, among all nations, your salvation. O God, let all the nations praise you. May the nations be glad and exult, because you rule the peoples in equity, the nations on the earth you guide. O God, let all the nations praise you. May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear him. O God, let all the nations praise you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me, believes not only in me, but also in the one who sent me. And whoever sees the one who sent me. I came into the world as light, so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. And if anyone hears my words and does not observe them, I do not condemn him, for I did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. Whoever rejects me and does not accept my words has something to judge him, the word that I spoke. It will condemn him on the last day, because I did not speak on my own. But the Father who sent me commanded me what to say and speak, and I know that his commandment is eternal life. So what I say as the Father told me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So the reason that we're not singing today is it's only 6 in the morning. The seminarians have exams today, so I think just out of charity, we're not going to try to sing with our voices not fully awake. But that being said, we have this powerful gospel. We're we are beckoned to meditate on the Trinity, on God himself, and God's love for us and our participation. Bishop Barron, in his morning reflections on today's gospel, he said, the Trinity is just another way of saying that God is love. But this has to imply that there is a play within the unity of the God of lover, beloved, and shared love. And he talks about, you know, that, you know, we know about God, that God is this eternal relationship of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And he goes on, this love is so white hot, so intense, that it spills over into creation. In the case of human beings, this communication and love was interrupted by sin. What did God do in order to address this problem? He says, God so loved the world that he gave his Son so that everyone believes him might not perish, but might have eternal life. And so God sent his Son so we could participate in his divine life. And that's what Christianity is participating in God's love. And so what about this whole thing of condemnation? Well, if you look at it, is that God pursues us, right? And that's true every single day of our life. And it, from our, he made us out of love for love to love him eternally. And that's God's will, that we're with him forever in heaven. He made us to be in heaven. That is his ultimate will. But with that comes free will. You know, we have the chance to reject his love, you know, namely through serious sin, or just to turn away from him ultimately. And that's something that he will allow us to do if we want. But notice that is not God condemning us, it's we condemning ourselves by not accepting the invitation to be with him forever in heaven, right? I mean, the whole thing about heaven, if you think about heaven, what is heaven? It is being with God in this total loving, ultimate, red hot loving relationship for eternity, which we can't even explain, it's so awesome. I think if we meditate on heaven more, we'd probably live better. but the ultimate's also true, is that we can choose to deny this invitation to go to this beautiful party with him forever. And so today, you know, we choose God, you know, in little ways, in big ways, so that we can participate in the life of the Trinity. And now we bring our petitions to the Lord. We pray for our church, we pray for the Holy Father, we pray for all priests, deacons, and religious around the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our government. We pray that they enact laws to protect all human life from conception till natural death, and also find suitable ways to bring us back to work and to deal with this pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the sick and suffering. We pray especially for all those that are just in great need of prayers and intercession at this moment. They're going through great suffering, whatever that might be, that God may aid them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray today for the soul of Mark Milinek. We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory. And also we pray for the soul of Michael, who is the father of Tammy Samega, who died this morning at Sage Point, that he may be with our Lord Jesus in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we just take a brief moment and bring our personal attentions to the Lord in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we turn to Our Lady and ask for her powerful intercession as together we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And we ask all these things through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Humble, contrite heart, accepted by the merry sacrifice, be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me of my iniquities and cleanse me from all of my sin. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is a ransom from death, and his rising the life of all who has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sunt caelia terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church, be pleased to grant her peace to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Wilton, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, especially Tammy Samega, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise that they offered for themselves, and all who are dear to them for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Lioness, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and count among the flock of those you have chosen through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with his eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mysterium Fidei,
Mortem Tuam Annunciamus Domine, et Tuam Resurrectionem Confitemur, Donec Venias.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension to heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar and high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants, especially Mark Milanek and Michael, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who are sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but grant us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with light, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. this moment, I invite all of you to make a spiritual communion, to ask the Lord to convict you of his love for you, and also, you know, and also acknowledge the fact that if you're in a state of grace, that God lives inside of you, you know, that you yourself are a tabernacle, and that he is present inside of you at all times when we're free of serious sin. So, and thank God for that, you know. Communion antiphon. I have chosen you from the world, says the Lord, and I've appointed you to go and bear fruit that will last. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. Amen. So today is 1 week away from the ride, reparation ride, that myself and the two seminaries at Father Bob will be doing. We just thank you all for your generosity, and you know, you can still donate to the cause, and afterwards we'll announce, you know, how much we raised for the poor, and for the also for first responders, to sort of give them maybe gift cards and a token of appreciation for all the hard work they're doing during this time. Also online, you can still sign up for the women's retreat, this online retreat that will start Friday night. Three talks, myself and Father Bob, we give in Friday and Saturday. Information's online, you can sign up there. And schedule will be put on shortly, you know, for today's prayer and opportunities for the Sacrament of Reconciliation. Have a blessed day. And also we pray for the seminarians that we get through these finals well, and pass with flying colors. And all those that are also college students, if you're watching this Mass, we're praying for you. Probably right now you're in the midst of finals, that you do well in your studies. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, and by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits
that prowl about the world seeking their own souls.
Amen.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in splendor with Jesus our King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.